Fight date, September the 15th, Victoria Warehouse. First VIP show of the season.
Yeah.
And it's looking like a good show. And tell us about your preparations, man.
Just training as always, you know. I don't know who I'm fighting yet. I'm guessing it's going to be a six rounder again. Not really been busy this year, as I would like to be, but you know, I'll just get this one out of the way, then hopefully get on a Frank Warren show. Then have a busy year next year and get some titles under my belt.
It is a six rounder, this one. I've looked on Box Rec.
Okay, well, there you go.
Is it going to be a last six rounder? I mean, are you looking to step up to eight rounds soon?
Yeah, I want to. I thought, you know, obviously, that's what I want to do. You obviously want to build up, though, so this should be my last six rounds and eight rounds and titles then. And anyone
in
it.
I mean, in reality, you've been an 8 and 10 round fighter for a while anyway, haven't you, really?
I think so. Sparring the round, so I don't know what to say why I can't do it in a fight. We have to see when it happens.
There's a lot of good sparring around at your weight, in the lightweight division, isn't there? You get a lot of good lads in here.
Good sparring, good fights, good everything.
Yeah.
It's a good division to be in.
Yeah. You've been working on your jab today, I've seen. You know, you do these drills where you spend hours working just on certain shots, one shot.
Yeah.
That's part of the game, isn't it?
Well, the jab is the best punch in the game. It sets everything up, you know. There's only very few fighters that can box and not jab. And if you haven't got a jab in boxing, then really, that's probably the first punch you learn when you come into the gym is the jab. So just because you can do it doesn't mean you don't work on it. And we work on it a lot, which is why I feel like my jab is as good as it is. But it can be better, and it can always be better. So that's what we keep it fun. You know, like we do in the gym, when you see him before, we keep it points and you get hit, you're out and stuff like that. So it's just, I know, it's good to be able to mix boxing and fun up, because boxing's hard enough as it is.
You've been obviously stopping a lot of people, like 8 stoppages in 11.
Yeah.
You're on this show now, which is being streamed on the VIP stream, which is always, you know, a lot of people watch it.
Yeah.
But you're going to have to compete, because everyone on this particular bill, it's first show of the season, they're
good. Little Bradley Ray's.
Yeah, Brad Ray's pro debut. There's people like Danny Wright. There's loads of other good kids on it. Kane Gardner, lots of others. I don't want to go through it in case I miss anyone, but they're all at the stage where they want to make a statement, so you have to go some to steal the show, aren't you, really?
I'm not trying to steal no show. Everyone can have the limelight, but you know, I just want to fight. And obviously everyone's good and tight. I'm looking forward to some of them, some of the fights as well. You know, I want to see Bradley's first fight. I want to see him. I've known him for quite a long from amateurs and stuff like that, so I'm excited to see that, as well as see my own fight and stuff like that. So if I steal in the limelight, we'll just have to see which opponent I get and what that opponent brings to me and stuff.
You know what sort of opponent I'd like to see you in with? Some, you know, the next few fights, someone really tall and really rangy.
Yeah.
Who's going to jab? Because we've seen the short, stocky guys, we've seen the come forward, we've seen the guys that have sort of been more defensive minded, but tall, rangy, jabber. Because
I'd like to see someone that hits me.
Someone that
hits me.
Someone that hits you?
Yeah.
Is that what you want? Yeah. You want to get smacked there?
I want someone to at least try hard.
Yeah.
Obviously, I'm just a fighter, so that's a fight who Pat tells me to fight. But from next year, I want to fight. It is what it is, isn't it? I want. Can't be in boxing for too long. You know what I mean? You want to get in and get out with all your faculties. You know what I mean?
Are you saying then that, you know, if you, let's just say you were to get I'm not going to go down, we've already talked names and all that stuff in the past, but you know, if you were to get like a big fight put on the table, you know, with say 4-6 weeks notice, you know, are you saying that your mentality right now is you'd
I'm
get
I'm
in
not,
there?
I'm not stupid, so I won't go into a fight that, I'll never go into a fight where I won't go into a big fight with less preparation than the need. I'm going to go into a big fight with proper preparation, but if the fight comes up where it's like a lifetime opportunity, and obviously any fighter will take it, and I'm the same, I'm a fighter, so I fight anyone with the right preparation. So for as long as I'm staying in the gym and I'm fit anyway, 4 to 6 weeks is a little more than enough. You're talking big fights, you want, obviously you want the full thing, but as far as what you just said, then, of course.
A lot of the lads from the GB squad, and you know, that you know from the scene, are doing really well at the minute.
Yeah, everyone's smashing the shit out of life.
They are, aren't they?
So, yeah, I'm happy for them, man. It's good. it's good. It's good that, you know, boxing's changed a lot of people's lives around. So it's great to watch. It's great to watch the come up as well, man. It's great. Anthony Joshua's obviously a lot to do with a lot of this as well. He's doing big for the British scene and stuff like that. So
yeah, he is. What's your views on that, having to fight someone who you actually know quite well? You know, because obviously that's going to happen at some point. You're going to have to fight someone who you've either sparred with a lot, you know well, you're cool with.
It's boxing, isn't it? It's a job. It's not a hate. You never want the person to die you fighting, but or get injured seriously bad or anything like that. But it's boxing. It's a job. It's just a job. It's entertainment. You have no hate towards the person. You just like might have hate towards him in the camp or in the fight gate or in the fight, because obviously you're about to try and punch this person. This person's trying to punch you. So, but as far as it is what it is, what else can you do? It has to happen.
Have you noticed anything since you started your professional career where you've you look back at those fights and see massive improvements in certain areas?
In me?
Yeah.
In my pro fights? Mm. I don't think you'll see that of me yet. Mm. I've not had the opponent to say, I'm doing this better, I'm doing that better. I don't think you've seen anything. Whatever. The fighters I'm fighting now, I could have fought them when I was an amateur. Mm. So I don't... Obviously, I'm doing what I need to do. I'm getting them out of there, I'm knocking them out, but... And I'm stopping them, but as far as saying there's an improvement, you'd only probably see that in sparring. Mm. These guys I'm fighting are not really bringing the best out of me.
You sound a bit frustrated with the level of guys you're fighting.
Not so much frustrated, because I'm on my path and this is it, this is the boxing, but you'll see the best in me in good time, do you know what I mean? Mm. I don't see it yet with the opponents that I've had.
Okay. Well, like I say, we've not had the opponent named for the 15th, but as we've alluded at, it's probably going to be your last six rounder, and then the step up will happen, and then those fights will happen, man.
Yeah.
Those will happen. It's all been as you said to me in the past. Trust the process.
Yeah, you've got to. I believe your life's your path set in it. Like, I believe that what's going to happen is going to happen regardless. So you just have to let. You just have to. Flow with the punches.
He's starting to get like his helper now with the little one-liners, flowing with the punches. All right, man. Is there anything you want to add?
Just come on, watch me on the 15th. Come and support, and continue to support me throughout my career, because it should be a fun ride.
Get on board with that ride. All right, you heard it here from Lyndon King Arthur. He's out again. 15th of September at Victoria Warehouse on Steve Wood's show. Tune in. Aki Kareem, British Boxers, you know the score. Power.